guruma. So we did sasai suru kameshi, but I want you to take a double elbow for this one here and step. And then step the other way. Here. Just be a bit more specific about where you put your foot. On the side of the knee, here. Just, I know it's not the most pretty leg, but on the side of the kneecap, just here. That's where you put the foot. There's a spot there. When you do guruma techniques, like Ashi guruma, that's where you put your leg on the side, and it comes across, catches the person on the side, then their leg breaks. It breaks posture. As soon as you break posture, you get the throw. And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to break their posture here. Get the technique. And we'll try it on the other side, just because it's a good routine to learn. Here. No. Don't fall over. No. Find it. Don't cooperate. It's too easy, you're not cooperating. Just be uncooperative, they've got to get their foot in the right place. Yeah. Otherwise it's a waste of time. So for a starter, Hiza guruma both sides, and then Ashi guruma. Ashi guruma requires a circular step. Outside and lift the leg. Then come across. A circle step. Out the side, put your foot in the air. It's like sideways calisthenics, right? Here, out the side, draw their balance forwards and down. This is a forwards and down balance breaking, like that. This hand's drawing in this direction, this hand's drawing parallel to the mat. Drawing the person down and forwards, sideways step, then shoot your leg across the front. Okay? Yeah, change the grip. Ashi guruma, Hiza guruma, both ways. Ashi guruma, Hiza guruma, both ways. Try that.